Happy birthday, Keith. Welcome to being 60. We're still moving forward. We still got a lot of strength left in our legs. And I just wanted to say I'm thankful to have you as a friend. I appreciate having you in my life and also being a brother in the Lord. I hope that I'm there for your birthday party, but I might be driving my daughter back from Flagstaff that weekend. But we will see each other. Take care, my friend. Bye-bye.
Okay.
Happy birthday, Keith.
Happy birthday. 60 years old. You so old, you poot dust.
You're catching up with me, Pod, and I can't believe you're 60.
Sorry we couldn't make it. Have a good one.
Love you.
Love you. Bye.
Hey, Mr. Keith. I just wanted to stop in and wish you a happiest 60th birthday. I know Miss Carol and Alicia and Karen and Jackson and Joseph are going to make it one heck of a party. Thank you for also being there for Karen and I's crazy adventures through the years. You've been like a dad to me, and I hope you have the greatest day ever. Love ya.
Hey, Florence, coming at you not live, all the way from Djibouti, Africa. I want to wish you the happiest of birthdays. 60 is a big deal, so celebrate, live it up like it's not 2020. Gonna ruin your surprise here, but headed your way is a miniature asteroid. Got them all over the place here. I triple them quite frequently, but this way, when the Babineaux boys are coming over, you can just hide them, and there won't be any garden aesthetics ruined in the process. It is coming via USPS. This is my personal plug. Send a greeting card, send your ballot, go vote, but that is enough business. Really, Parent, I just wanted to say I love you. I wish I was there to celebrate with you. When I come home, we can celebrate by you making us a big old pot of jambalaya. Happy, happy birthday. I love you. I'll stay out of trouble.
Hey, Keith, happy birthday. Happy 60th. You only look 65. You look great. We're praying for you. Hope everything goes well tonight. You enjoy your night. Happy birthday, Keith. Talk to you soon.
Hey, Keith. This is Coach. Happy birthday. I'd sing it to you. My voice got some cracks on it, so I'll save you the agony. I am so privileged that you asked for me to speak a little bit, but I'll make it brief. I really appreciate you older guys, you much younger than me, letting me tag along and play the games with you. And the older I get, and the more meaningful those moments are. And I really appreciate the fellowship. I appreciate you guys doing that. But that's triviality. Number one, I'm so proud of the man you have become. I'm proud of the way your faith has developed, your love of the Lord. When all is said and done, that is the most important thing. And I always like to quote this scripture, Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. And Keith, in 20 more years, you'll be able to celebrate your fourth 20th birthday. Love you, Coach.
Happy birthday, Tara. Love you.
Hi, Mr. Keith. Happy birthday. We were asked to think of our favorite memories or good things to say about you on your 60th birthday. And I guess, how do you pick one when they were all good? We were frequent at the house from probably middle school all the way through high school and even then some. And I often came in a pair, which I know at times could certainly be overwhelming, but you never showed it, and you were always so welcoming, Miss Carol, too. Perhaps that's the best part, that you welcomed us, both of you did, and I know at times that me, Jesse, and Karen could be high energy. But you took us as we were, and you encouraged a beautiful friendship that lasts until today. So I'll always be grateful for that. I hope you have a wonderful day. I'm going to pray that all the joys of the day are yours. Happy birthday.
Hey, Keith. Happy birthday. Just reminding you that you're getting old. Hope you have a special day.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Mr. Keith. I'll have to come up with some new dad jokes for you. Love you. Bye.
Happy birthday, Mr. Keith. 60 is a big one, so I just wanted to take a minute to say that I'm super bummed out that I couldn't be at your party. But, wow, it's amazing to think that I have known you for more of my life than I haven't known you. I remember you most clearly from about 10 years old on. That's when Karen and I started being really good friends. My favorite memories, some of my favorite memories of being a kid are going to your house on the weekends and just being welcomed with open arms as if I was one of your own. And when I think back on being a kid, part of those memories involve being at the Babineaux house on weekends, days after school. Anytime we needed a ride anywhere, either you or Miss Carol did that for us. My favorite, absolute favorite memory of you, and I think Skylar and Karen will love this, in addition to being that dad that Karen was always kind of embarrassed of, which always makes me laugh because I just thought you were awesome, driving the three of us to see Ryan Cabrera, and we were like 18 or 19 at the time, so it's not like actually we were kids. We probably could have driven ourselves, but it was New Orleans. We were nervous. We didn't necessarily want to go by ourselves, and so you drove us, and we went and ate at the Hard Rock. Yikes, but we went and ate at the Hard Rock Cafe, and we went to the House of Blues for a concert that was like kind of a boy band, and you were totally out of your element. I remember Karen being terrified that you were just going to start singing or dancing or being silly, but the fact that you were willing to do that, just take three college girls to a show to see a boy band type pop singer, the fact that you were willing to do that for us spoke volumes then, and it speaks volumes now. Like I said, some of the best memories from being a kid involve you and Miss Carol and the whole Babineaux family. Y'all truly made me feel like I was one of your own growing up. So thank you for that. I hope you have a wonderful 60th year. And hopefully for 61, I'll be able to see you in person and celebrate with you then. So thank you for my childhood and for being such a huge part of it. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, my friend.
Whoa! What?
Liquor
50! Happy birthday!
Happy birthday,
who's that? Keith, Nanny would like to wish you a happy 60th birthday. Golly, man, boy, I wish I could be there. Happy birthday, my baby.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, old man. Now you're joining me and Bob. Hope you have a great year. Love you.
Happy birthday.
Bye.
Happy birthday, Keith.
Hey, I want to wish you a happy birthday. First of all, I want to thank you for helping me get my head out of my ass. After Matt passed away in the flood and everything, you got me going. I appreciate it. You have a nice birthday, and I'll check you out later. Thank you.
For God so loved Bab that he gave him basketball. And Bab said, where two or more gathered, there is game. And Cliff said, suffer the little players to come to my house. Come all who have good medical insurance, and we will give you bruises. And Bab says, if we pass it to Nichols, surely he will shoot. And Coach said, "Well done, Bab. You made another year. Happy birthday."
Okay. Happy birthday, Keith, and many more. Love you and Irene.
Happy birthday, Pop. We love you.
I love you, too.
I hope you enjoy this big milestone of a birthday. Happy 60th birthday. To think when I met you, I didn't have this little munchkin right here. He's 7 years old. I think Jackson was about 8 or 9 whenever I met you guys. Thanks for taking me in under your wing and treating me like a part of the family, like a daughter that you adopted in. I will always love you and Miss Carol and everyone else for as long as I live. I hope you've enjoyed your birthday party that Karen is planning, and I'm sorry I didn't get to go. But I will be thinking about you, so enjoy your day and enjoy your party. We love you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Bye.
Bye-bye again.
Happy birthday, cuz. Sorry we couldn't be there to enjoy your party. Trying to think of a funny experience from our past. Can't think of a whole lot, but I can think of a couple of things that might have gotten us in trouble. Like leaving Gonzales about 7 o'clock in the evening and hauling butt to Lafayette to party with our friends in Lafayette at 16 years old and crossing the Atchafalaya Bridge at midnight, hauling ass, trying to beat curfew. I don't think Aunt Lush would have took that too kindly if we would have gotten caught, but it was fun. Happy birthday.
Now, happy birthday, father-in-law. I hope you have a good birthday.
Hey, Dad, we just wanted to say happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Keith.
Sorry that we can't be there today. We both have to work, but we hope you have a wonderful day, surrounded by your friends, family, and loved ones. Even though I can't be there, it's okay. It's okay. Favorite daughter, it's okay. But thank you for always welcoming me into your home and including me as part of your family and all the favors you've done and driving me to the airport and Christmas Day and just always treating me like one of your own. We love you. Happy birthday.
Happy 60th, Keith.
And have a wonderful day.
Hey, Pops. Happy 60th birthday. Love you. Yes, I can go off on Monday.
Happy 60th birthday, Pops. I love you and thank you for taking me to church on Sunday. Thank you. Bye.
Happy birthday, Dad. Love you.
Hey, Dad. One of my favorite memories was when I was about 4 years old. We went to Corpus Christi for a vacation. And, you know, we went ride horses out at, I think it was Mustang Island. And we had a rather kind of bad experience, I guess. But we were riding that horse cowboy, I believe was his name. And he didn't want to go anywhere. And we basically got stuck at the beginning of the little trail ride and didn't do much of anything, but I was with you, and it was one of the best moments of my life because it was just you and me riding a horse, and I guess it just stuck with me, and it was just one of my favorite memories of us. And I also just wanted to say that I appreciate everything you've done for me. Everything that you have done has made me into the person I am today. You're such a caring, loving father, person, husband, everything. And you're my brother in blue, which is really, really close to me. And that I just want you to know, always got your back, no matter what it is. And hopefully one day we get to ride together. That'd be awesome. Love you, Dad. Happy birthday.
Okay, so this is like take number 8 or 9. And so if it doesn't work out this time, you just gonna get all my bloopers. So I just want to say happy birthday, Dad. You are the most amazing man that I know. I am so lucky to have you as my father. I'm lucky to have you as a role model to both of my children. And I just want to thank you for being the man you are and for taking care of us the way you have done our entire lives. You have always believed in us, believed in everything we wanted to do, and just pushed us to be the, you know, people we have become. When I think back on my favorite memories, a couple of things come to mind. So number one is a double ditty, and my siblings will understand that. Nobody else might, but they do. And number two was a time when you wanted me to get my haircut really short, and I wasn't really into that. And so you bribed me with an extra piece of chocolate cake if I would go the next day and get my haircut off. And you know, this food-loving girl took that piece of cake, and the next day I went and got my hair chopped off, and it looked terrible. Thank you, Dad, for making me look terrible. But I absolutely love you, and I am honored to have been able to put this birthday party together for you, because you deserve it. You deserve the world. Sorry. You truly are an amazing man. And I absolutely love you, Dad. And I hope you have had a fantastic birthday party. And I hope you just have a wonderful 60th year and lots more years to come. And like Coach Johnny said, in 20 years, you'll be celebrating your fourth 20th birthday, and hope we can do this again. So I love you, Dad, and I hope you have a fantastic evening. Love your favorite daughter.
She's a good girl. She's Daddy's favorite.
Happy birthday, Dad. I hope you were super surprised. I hope that you love the whole party. I have cats helping me. I hope that everyone that showed up is having a great time. And most importantly, I hope that you had the best 60th birthday. For anyone who doesn't know, my dad adopted me. He came into my mom's life, did something really dumb so that he could go back and meet her. It's a fun story. You should ask her about it. And then ended up keeping both of us. He adopted me and married my mom. Gave me 3 siblings, which, you know, I'm the favorite. That's all that matters. Goodness. Overall, Keith Babineaux is a good man. Sometimes he's a complete pain in my butt. But he is a good man. He is someone that most people are lucky to have in their lives, and I am also lucky to have him in my life. So, Dad, I love you. Thank you. I hope you had the best 60th birthday. And, hold on. Oh. Leffy also says happy birthday. Hi, Leff. Say hi. I know. I'm sorry. She's been attacking my hand this whole time. I figured she deserved to be in the video. So, again, I love you. Happy birthday. I hope it's the best day. I hope we successfully surprised you. And if not, pretend that we did. Just let us have this.
Like we made it. Happy 60th birthday, Keith. Where do I begin? We met over 34 years ago, and you brought your vehicle in for a windshield seal. Got it done. You came and picked your car up, and before you left, I let you know
All the do's and don'ts, and the biggest don't was you do not pressure wash that windshield on any level or fashion for at least 24 hours. And I'm picking up because you come as late as you can and we're closing. And I'm watching out the window as I'm picking up everything and putting it away. And what do I see but this idiot guy picks up his vehicle, goes straight across airline to the self-serve car wash where Piccadilly is now, and he's pressure washing. Called both of my bosses in. I'm like, are you kidding me? Look at this. He goes, oh, that son of a bitch, are you? Oh, I said, sup. That's what my boss said. And he's like, I can't, and he's coming back. I said, so do I get to talk to him like you just talked to me about him? He goes, you can't say that, but you can tear into him if you'd like. And I do believe I called you an idiot, and how stupid could you be? And then, Dave, if after we don't arrange to fix it again, 2 weeks later, you come back with a busted quarter glass needing it to be fixed. And this time you decide to sit around and wait for it after it had come in and you were dropped off. And you're talking about tennis and you offer to give me a tennis lesson, which 34 plus years later, I'm still waiting for a tennis lesson. Still love you, waiting for more adventures, and I hope you love the party.
I'd like to point out that we didn't have any bloopers. That was a first shot. So all those awkward videos of Alicia and her teeth, enjoy them.
I'm bad at this. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Keith.
Thanks for 60 years.
Happy birthday, father-in-law. I'm busting my ass right now for your party this evening.